everyone. It's Bretta Riches from runforfoot.com, and today I'm going to be talking to you about why you may be getting sore calves when you first learn forefoot running, whether you're barefoot or whether you are doing so in barefoot-inspired running shoes. I get a lot of comments and questions about why the sore calves when learning forefoot running, so I just want to reiterate why your calves may become sore when learning forefoot running. Like I said, whether you are doing so barefoot or whether you are doing so in barefoot-like running shoes. It's important to note that the calves have a different and distinct mechanical task in forefoot running than they do in heel strike running. So because of this, you will get some sort of calf soreness. Depending on your fitness level and running experience, you may encounter mildly sore calves or extremely sore calves. Now, calf soreness is a well-known form of soreness related to the early stages of learning forefoot running. In forefoot running, the calves have a more tight control over balance, spring behavior, as well as shock absorption than in heel strike running. And because of this, there will be a massive surge in muscle activation in the calves as well. But don't forget that the calf activity is not exhaustive in forefoot running. And what I mean by that is the more you run forefoot, the more the calves will strengthen and become a more valuable spring contributor to forefoot running. In a sense, forefoot running is in part powered by the calf muscles. With more forefoot running experience, the calf pain will completely diminish and will have a profound effect on your calf strength. Now, in heel strike running, the calf activity is more repressive and the knee does a lot of the mechanical work, which can foster, based on mechanical overload, can foster runner's knee. So just to compare the mechanical behavior of the calf muscles in forefoot running versus in heel strike running, and to give you a better understanding as to why your calves may become sore when learning forefoot running, one study confirmed that the calf muscle activation duration in forefoot running lasted longer than the calf muscle activation duration in heel strike running. The research paper, which I will link below in the description box, found that habitual or highly experienced forefoot runners activated their calf muscles on average 9.7% longer duration than heel strike runners. The researchers also found that forefoot runners activated their lateral calf muscles 6.3 to 14.3% longer in duration than in heel strike running at slow, moderate, and fast speeds. So what this data means is that forefoot running livens the calf muscles more so than in heel strike running. In forefoot running, the calves are more mechanically on board and collaborate more with the ankles to provide a stronger, steady, sturdy support base for your forefoot strike landing when you run. So that's the principal reason for your calf soreness and tightness. And that, again, in forefoot running, the calves are more engaged mechanically and energetically than in heel strike running. And because your calves aren't used to being put to this kind of work in this capacity, your calves just need a period of time to adapt. So embrace the soreness. It's not a big deal. Even though blowtorched feeling calves might be alarming for some, it typically does not signal that you are doing anything wrong at the mechanical level, but rather this soreness is a constructive role in the adaptation of the leg to forefoot running. So for more information on the performance and health benefits of forefoot running, please visit my blog, runforfoot.com, where you will also find information on the health benefits of barefoot running as well. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel to stay updated on all the latest research regarding the biomechanics of running, as well as scientifically backed nutritional information for endurance running as well. Thanks so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads. Bye for now.